morning everyone. I'm Srija. My topic is the study of food abnormalities and the use of 3D surface scanner in their measurement and assessment. So as we all know, foot is an important structure in the body which aids in locomotion, and it's also the weight bearing part which dissipates and absorbs the forces from the reactions area. The functioning of the foot is affected by various conditions like the congenital conditions such as club foot, flat feet, and we have acquired conditions like diabetic foot, hallux valgus, foot ulcerations, clotos, and there are manual fractures of calcaneus, tibia, etc. All these conditions require management by using foot orthotics which provide pain relief, increase cushioning, correct the deformities, and increase the stability. So recent days, customized foot orthotics are considered as a benchmark in this treatment. Various tools are used for measurement of the foot pattern, for preparing foot prosthetics. The conventional methods are calipers, ink footprint, and the plaster castings. Recent technology has allowed us to use 3D scanner, which has high advantages like high accuracy, speed, low operation cost, harmless to patients, and fewer limitations. So I used 3D scanner. The aim and objectives of the study are to find out foot deformities in all age groups and to create awareness, and to measure the foot arch length, arch height, and base circumferences accurately and precisely using the scanner. The methods and the methodology, it's a cross-sectional study which was done in hospital in the OPD of orthopedics. It was a 3-month duration and 35 subjects was of different age groups were collected. It was conducted after taking permission from the ethics, and the history and social demographic profile of the patient was taken. Informed consent was taken from the patient. This tool is the 3D scanner, which is pre-calibrated, which is low-end and portable device. Well, the data was analyzed in a software called Rhino. So this is the 3D scanner I have used. And these are the parameters I have measured. This is the normal foot scan image of obtained from the 3D scanner. This is a procedure done in this software called Rhino for measuring. Coming to results and observations, according to age and sex, we have found maximum participants in 12 to 21 age group. And according to the foot condition, the normal foot were of 42%, the abnormal were 57%. And these were the abnormalities found, and maximum condition was a flat foot, which is 25%. And to assess the abnormality, the normal foot measurements obtained from the scan, from the study, were compared to the abnormal foot, the mean and standard deviation. This is the flat foot. The scan of the flat foot. Similarly, wide foot was assessed. Maljoint fractured foot, bilateral equinus foot, foot drop cases, the claw feet, sciatic nerve injury foot, and the non-healing ulcer and swelling. So on the assessment, we have found that in wide foot, there was no deviation in the fifth toe and the heel and circumference was increased. The flat foot, the arch height and the height of lateral point of lateral mandibles was decreased. In the bilateral equinus foot, the foot length, arch height and the medial mandibular height was increased compared to the normal foot measurements. In the acquired conditions, in such as in foot drop, the foot length was decreased, the height of both mandibles was decreased, the ball head circumference was increased and the foot length was increased. In sciatic nerve injury, we have found all the parameters were reduced, maybe due to wasting. In swelling and ulcers, the surface area was measured. Coming to future implications, there can be more research conducted in the foot abnormalities, and 3D scanner can be used with clinicians to measure and assess. And the data can be directly used in 3D printing technology for production of orthotics, insoles and prosthetics. Other uses of 3D scanner are, it can be used in production of medical devices, it can be used in attending diagnosis such as in telemedicine, and implants and prosthetics can be made, can be used in monitoring and visualization in post-surgical corrections. The limitations of my study were, it was a high initial setup cost, and due to lack of automated analysis, I have conducted a study on fewer subjects. And the conclusions are, it can be used as a clinical tool in the hospital for assessment of deformities. Scan of every patient can be done for
back to your slide of the photograph of the scanner.
Yes.
How the scanner works basically?
Yes, sir. Because of lack of time, I didn't put the slide about the working of scanner. So that is the device I've used. It's working with the iPad. So basically, it gives infrared rays and takes back the data, like whatever is reflected from the whatever the rays are reflected by the object that is collected, and then the scanner arranges it in a STL file. Like it prepares triangular materials and it makes the entire surface. It builds the surface out of the scan.
The procedure to take the scan, you have to identify any pixel, boning points, landmarks, initial.
Yes. After the scan is taken, the data is analyzed in a software called Rhinocer. It is a 3D designing software. So in that, I have made cross sections of the feet. So based on that, we can assess, and based on that, I have found the bony deform, like the medial point and the lateral point could be found out. Even the skin surface area is also scanned.
How often you are supposed to calibrate this instrument?
I have calibrated twice, ma'am, in the wherever I was working. That's it. Before I was scanning, I just calibrated once. The software sets itself.
So there is no particular protocol for the calibration. So usually for each equipment, the calibration should be repeated after 6 months or 1 year and then.
Yes, ma'am. This is automated calibrate. So it calibrates based on the room. I mean, I have to scan the entire room and it calibrates itself.
The sensitivity of this, not sensitivity, specificity of your scanner when compared to your clinical judgment or radiological judgment. See, in assessing a flat foot or thyroid pneumovirus, we often take X-rays and we measure certain angles.
Yes, sir.
Right? So, by that we come to a conclusion, the severity of the deformity. By using this scanner, how it will be different from your clinical or radiological judgment? What is the specificity of your scanner?
Yes, sir. Already, if we get the diagnosis, in preparation of orthotics, this is more useful. Because using my conventional methods, we cannot get accurate and precise measurements of the arch heights, arch length, or the correction, like in podiatrics, how they do the wedges and all, how they place.
So this is the design, deception, designing your orthotics.